So we've talked about derivatives and seen the definition. Since we make this definition in terms of limits, we start to wonder, are some of the limit laws able to be translated into derivative laws? The answer is yes, but we have to be careful. Let's see some examples. Okay, I'm given two different functions, we'll call them f and g, and I add these two functions together to give me a new function. I want to ask myself, what is the derivative of this new function? I'm hoping that our limit laws will help us to figure this out. The definition of the derivative says that if I want to take the derivative of these two things, I calculate the limit. So the derivative of f of x plus g of x is equal to the limit as h goes to 0 of what do? Well, the first thing I do is plug in x plus h everywhere I have an x in the function. So this is f of x plus h plus g of x plus h. And then I subtract, plugging in just x. So here I have f of x plus g of x. I divide by h and figure out what the limit is. So let's do a little bit of algebra here. I can simplify, distribute this in negative sign. So I have the limit as h goes to 0 of f of x plus h plus g of x plus h minus f of x minus g of x, and this is all over h. Now, I rearrange these terms so that the f's are nearby and the g's are nearby. So I have the limit as h approaches 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x plus g of x plus h minus g of x, and this is all over h still. Now I know that if I have two terms in the top of a fraction, I can set each of them in their own individual fraction as long as I keep the same denominator. This is sort of the reverse of how we add fractions. So using that idea, a little bit of algebra, this is the same as f of x plus h minus f of x over h plus g of x plus h minus g of x, again, all over h. It's important that the h here is in both denominators. And if you add these fractions back together, you'll see that you do, in fact, get this. Now, here comes the part where I need my limit laws. I know that the limit of a sum is the sum of the limits. So, I have the limit as h goes to 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x all over h plus the limit as h goes to 0 of g of x plus h minus g of x all over h. And now I look at what I have here and I recognize that this is just the definition of the derivative of f. And this is just the derivative of g. So what I have here after all of this algebra is the derivative of f plus the derivative of g. And in fact, that's exactly what we were trying to prove. We started with the derivative of f of x plus g, and I end up with the derivative of f plus the derivative of g. So now we've seen that the derivative of a sum is the sum of the derivatives. So anytime I have two functions added together and I want to take the derivative, I can just take the derivative of the individual pieces and then add the derivatives together. That's great. There are more limit laws though. Let's check out another one. Suppose I'm given some function f and some number a, right? I call this a constant because it's just a number and it's not changing depending on x. So now I multiply my function times this coefficient a, and I want to show that I can just factor this a right out of the derivative. So let's again use the definition of the derivative to figure out why this is true. Well, again, the definition of the derivative here is d dx of a times f of x is the limit as h goes to 0 of, what do? I plug in x plus h everywhere I have an x. So I have a times f of x plus h. I subtract f of x, which is my function, the whole thing, a times f of x, and then I divide by h. right? So I have the function evaluated at x plus h, the function evaluated at x. I subtract those two, divide by h. This is the definition of the derivative. Now, I notice that I have an a in this term and an a in that term, so I can just factor it out. So this is the limit as h approaches 0 of a times f of x plus h minus f of x, just factoring out the a, all over h. Well, so this a doesn't really have anything to do with h, so I can pull it even off of the fraction. So I have limit as h approaches 0 of a times f of x plus h minus f of x all over h. Here comes the part where I use my limit laws. I know that since this a doesn't have anything to do with h, I can pull it right out of the limit. I know that the limit of a constant times some function is the constant times the limit. So this is a times the limit as h approaches 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x all over h. And again, I recognize this as the definition of the derivative of f. So replacing that, I have a times the derivative of f of x. But that's exactly what I wanted to prove, that anytime I have a constant, it factors out of the limit. So our limit laws have been really useful for these last two examples. Now we know that anytime I have a constant times a function, I can factor out that constant and just take the derivative of the function and multiply by the constant. That's really convenient when we start taking derivatives of polynomials. But these two limit laws were pretty easy. What about more complicated limit laws, like the limit of a product is the product of the limits? Can we figure out what's going on here? Okay, let's see an example of a different type. Now I have two functions, f and g, and I want to know if I take the derivative of the product of these functions, is it going to be the product of the derivatives? The limit laws would suggest that this is the case because we know that the limit of a product is the product of the limits. But in the case of derivatives, this does not work out. Let's see an example. Let's let f of x be the constant function 2 and g of x be the identity function x. Then we know that the derivative of f is 0 because it's a constant function, and the derivative of g is 1. We could either calculate these derivatives using the definition of the derivative, or we've maybe seen them in a previous video. So if I multiply these derivatives together, the derivative of f of x times the derivative of g of x, I get 0 times 1, or 0. But what happens if I take the derivative of f times g? Well, f of x times g of x is 2 times x, or just 2x. So the derivative of f of x times g of x is the derivative of 2x. And earlier in the video, we've seen that if I have a constant on the front of a function, I can pull that constant out in front of the derivative. So this is 2 times the derivative of x, or 2 times 1, which is 2. And 0 and 2 are different. So this fact is not actually true, that the derivative of the product is the product of the derivatives. We'll talk next week about what happens when I do have the product of two functions.